Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we are checking out the engineering responsible for the insane acceleration of Red Bull Global Rallycross Supercars. And to start off, I just have to say that experiencing this event firsthand was easily one of the most entertaining forms of motorsport I've been fortunate enough to check out. While the engineers and mechanics are problem solving 24/7, the fans are watching non-stop action as the cars blow tires, frequently make significant contact, lose parts, catch fire, and even drive completely blinded by their own hood. The cars themselves are pretty special too. Regulations limit them to 2-liter engines and 45mm turbocharger restrictor plates, which ultimately are the two factors limiting power. The engines produce about 600 horsepower and over 650 pound-feet of torque, rocketing these machines from 0 to 60 in as fast as 1.9 seconds. 1.9 seconds! If we do the math, 60 miles per hour is equivalent to 88 feet per second. 88 divided by 1.9 equals 46.3 feet per second squared, or if we divide by 32.2, it means the cars can accelerate at over 1.4 longitudinal Gs. That's faster than any production vehicle, regardless of how much it costs. So how do they achieve such mind-blowing acceleration? First and foremost, you'll need all-wheel drive and an absurd power-to-weight ratio. With a minimum weight of 2,921 pounds, including the driver and all fluids, the vehicles are carrying less than 5 pounds of weight for every horsepower the engine produces. All-wheel drive is obviously critical for maximizing acceleration, but it's also important that the engine torque finds its way to the wheels with the most traction. To do this, plate and ramp style mechanical limited slip differentials are used front and back. A shallow ramp angle in an LSD will lock up more easily under throttle. With the differential locked up, torque goes wherever it finds grip. A steep ramp angle will provide little lockup, or if it's as steep as 90 degrees, no lockup. If you use too shallow of an angle, you'll have too much lockup under cornering or braking, resulting in the car running wide. If you use too steep of an angle, you won't be able to fully put the power down to optimize your start or acceleration throughout the race. Often though, coming down to the precise angle is not only a matter of what's best from an engineering standpoint, but what the driver prefers as well, depending on how they like to attack the course. Now all of this sounds great so far, but ultimately the power gets put down where the rubber meets the road. BFGoodrich supplies their G-Force RC02 Rallycross tires, which are developed specifically and exclusively for Red Bull Global Rallycross. Built for 17-inch wheels with a profile of 235 over 45, the radial tires are molded slicks specially designed for mixed surface events. For both the front and the rear, BFGoodrich recommends negative 2 to negative 3 degrees of static camber with a cold tire pressure of 20 to 22 psi. The tremendous grip these tires provide is the last mechanical step of getting to 60 in less than 2 seconds. So, we've got an immensely powerful engine, all-wheel drive, specially tailored limited slip differentials, and super sticky tires. But there's one more element that has to tie all of this together for perfect execution, and that of course is the human element. To bring it all in, we head to none other than automotive legend, Tanner Faust.
So another thing, the start seems pretty critical. How do you ensure that you get a good start out here? What's kind of the process that you go through to make sure you can try and get ahead off the front?
Well, the human condition is one part of the process, and then they're setting the car up properly. In a human standpoint, I've been to a couple drag racing schools. Strangely, they're all taught by really old guys with huge bellies. And they just say the most important thing is to take a big breath.
Yeah.
Right? So I take a big breath. And then I focus on one bulb in one of the red light or one of the green lights. I focus exactly on one of those little LED lights. You have a sequence of events that literally clocks down from 30 second board, 10 second board. I drop it in gear. I get my hand on the ALS. See the first red light, flip ALS. You see the third light, you push the start button. You see all the lights, then you push the standby button and you pull the gear shift and you find the biting point, and then everything is about the green light.
He's got a race.
Yeah.
Good luck out there.
Yeah, thank you.
We need to go watch it. We got
all right,
an important
thanks,
job ahead of us.
All right, see ya.
Sounds good.
Of course, a huge thank you to Red Bull for sponsoring this video. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those below. Thanks for watching.